Good morning. This is another edition of How to Stop Using Drugs by Knowing You Through Divine Intervention. Before I begin with today's teaching, I'd like to read from the chapter of Chronicles, 2 Chronicles, 7th chapter, and we'll start with the 12th to the 14th verse. Because the Lord appeared to Solomon by night and said unto him, I have heard thy prayer and have chosen this place to myself for a house of sacrifice. If I shut up heaven that there be no rain, or if I command the locusts to devour the land, or if I send pestilence among my peoples, if my people, which are called by my name, shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven and will forgive their sin and heal thy land. My people, which are called by my name, shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven and will forgive thy sin and heal thy land. Our teaching today will come out the book of Revelation. Oh, what a great wonder it is that there appeared a great wonder in heaven. A woman clothed with the sun and the moon under her feet, and upon her head a crown of 12 stars. Now, this is a great wonder. And where did this woman come from? We don't hear theologians and scholars talk about this great wonder in heaven. Therefore, the Lord is going to reveal unto you today the mystery of this here great wonder. Because this woman was being with child. And being that she was getting ready to give birth to this man child, there stood before her, ready to devour the child, a great dragon, soon as the child was to be born. But the Lord gave this woman wings. Sister, do you have your wings yet? Praise the Lord. You should have had your wings by now, because God gave all women some wings that they can fly away from the face of the devil. And that's why we have people to this day church hop all over the city. They join this church, that church, that church, this church, because the face of that demon has showed his ugly face where she was at. So she flee from that church, help us, Lord, and go to another place where she abide there for some days until that ugly demon rears his ugly face all over again. This is why we have church hoppers in the house of the Lord. there's not perhaps two or three peoples that have been in the same church that they started in. Why? It's because of this great mystery of the Bible. And not only did this demon come to devour the child, he came to make war against the remnant of this woman's seed who bears the commandments of God and the testimony of Jesus Christ in their heart. You are already, praise the Lord, being sought by this devil to be devoured, to be killed, to be slaughtered. Your seed, it's in your Bible. God's word abides forever. And believe it or not, I'm at a building that I own, and it's hot outside. But it doesn't make no difference about the heat, nor to what length or depth I will go to try to save one person's soul. Because drugs is this demon, and it is the greatest weapon Satan has used against God, society, and you. When you use drugs, you become trapped by the demons of that addiction. And you cannot stop using drugs, even if you wanted to, because it's evil. This devil lives in the drugs, and you cannot get away. You cannot escape. You cannot go without seeking this devil. Even though you don't want this demon, even though you don't want this drug, even though you know it's killing you, it's hard to talk about it and experience that you're going through, because you're fighting the devil. Help us, child. And you're fighting this devil from the book of Revelation, showing that he came to make war against you. So when he gives you drugs and you become induced with drugs, you become a devil. Help us, Lord. You do devilish things. You do things that it's not you. That's why we need this book, How to Stop Using Drugs by Knowing You Through Divine Intervention. We need this book to deliver you from your addiction.